came up here about 10 years ago, I was staying with John Hall and Johanna, and John was producing an album I did on CBS at the time. And it's the first time I've ever been to Woodstock. I stayed with them, and I went to some of the clubs. I didn't know one club from another. The Espresso was a big deal at the time.
Yeah, yeah.
And the Joyous Lake was just a health food place. A health food restaurant, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And Dini's was somewhere else. It was closer to the Joyous Lake. That's all I remember, because I wasn't here that much. And I never came back to Woodstock again until 2 years ago. And it really changed. It's really nice. I like it. But I like Phoenicia better. You know, I like places like the real towns like Phoenicia better.
Folkerts and Gordon's and.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I mean,
I sometimes
think that places like that have Adolf Hitler still upstairs, hidden around somewhere. I get that feeling, you know. But otherwise, it's a real town, you know. Real, you know, they have things that are not just tourists.
Yeah.
Manny's is like the main reason I go to Woodstock is to buy the newspaper and eat at Manny's restaurant. That's about it, you know. You know?
You definitely get a cake.
this is based on like a lot of local legend that's going on around places like Arkansas. I just wrote this. It was snowing at midnight, I was driving alone to the night shift at the factory. I had a thermos full of coffee, a couple dollars on me, and a lot of troubles troubling me. As I drove round a curve near a cold empty church, I saw a man by the side of the road. I said, friend, you need a lift, the snow is getting thick. He said, sure, I'll ride a little bit with you. He got into the car, I didn't even hear the door. I said, where you headed for this bitter night? He said, everywhere I'll go, I got so much to show and there's so little hope left in sight. As we drove by the gas stations, diners and bars, through the neon American dream, I put on the news station, there was war in two nations and a killer loose in New Orleans. As my windshield blades fought the flakes away, I saw the stranger had tears in his eyes. Then he opened his mouth and he spoke out so loud in a voice that shook me by surprise. He said, Jesus is coming any day to save us all, wait and see. Jesus is coming this way, read it in the prophecy. Jesus is coming this way. I said, well, you really did it this time, Tom. You got a nut from a hospital bed. I wondered, did he have a gun or a blade? I started to pray, then he said, I mean you no harm, please don't be alarmed. It was the news that made me upset. Then we rounded a bend, there were lights flashing red and police cars around a bad wreck. I turned to the rider, but he wasn't there. The seat had a luminous glow. The car door was closed. Where the hell did he go? The cop waved me on down the road. When I got to my job, I heard the early reports of the wreck I passed moments ago, and of a man who appeared like a saint on the scene and brought the driver back to life in the snow. When the trooper approached him, he smiled, then he vanished. No footprints or tracks could they find. I needed my coffee. I opened my thermos, and the coffee had all turned to wine.
Yahoo!
Thank you.
very good. How are you?
Okay. All at the usual.
Oh, okay. Come on, Santa, cheer up. Things can't be all that bad. Let's get into the Christmas spirit. Shall we sing a Christmas song?
I don't know, LG.
Well, that's the way I feel. I don't know about singing either. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll put some Christmas songs on the jukebox, and that should cheer us both up. There's Santa Claus. Doesn't that song make you feel better? Doesn't that put you in a Christmas spirit?
It's true. I do like Brenda Lee.
That's right. That'll make you feel much better.
Deck those with boughs of holly.
That's it, Santa Claus. Keep going. I think you're doing great. I know before too much longer, I'll tell you what we'll do. Have a drink with me for Christmas, and I know that'll make you feel much better and help you put you in the spirit. Santa Claus, keep going. You're doing great.
Hey, what'd you find that stuff, LJ?
Oh, that's something really good. That's a good imported Canadian whiskey called Black Velvet.
Christmas spirit.
Christmas spirit. Plenty of it. Guaranteed to set you right off. Look at Santa.
Put her there, LJ.
Okay, Santa. I guarantee you'll find everybody at home by now.
Matt eats a night owl too, aren't you? Usually. I'm just up late all the time. A lot of musicians are. Right. You know, you can't help it. You break schedules. And you get up early, then you play a night on a Saturday night where you just play and play and play. And you get out of there at 5 o'clock.
And you're wired.
And then you're wired, and then you go out to eat. You go to some place to eat, any place that's open. You get back, the sun's up, and then you're still wired. You know, your body might be tired, but you're racing because you played all night.
What's it like at sunrise?
What's it like at sunrise? I love sunrise. It's beautiful. It's very calm, very beautiful. It really is.
Best time of the day.
It's so beautiful. I love going to bed when the sun is coming up, you know, like Dracula.
I have seen sunrise 10 times in my life.
10 times in your life? That's amazing. Well, everybody has their own, you know, their own clock, whatever it is.
You know? And each time it's been truly wondrous, really. The privacy of it.
Yeah, it's so pretty. Susie and I around, it was on the equinox, the spring equinox. They just went and just drove to a high point in near Kingston and watched the sun come up. It was so beautiful. The first day of spring, March 21st, and it was so beautiful. There was something. There were, you know, all the animals and wild or domesticated knew it, and they felt it because we were driving down, and I'd see deer at that hour of the day, which I normally see anyway, seemed more nervous or skittish, and I saw raccoons, and I saw possums and animals running all over, and they felt that the key had turned, and there was a change. It was now, winter was over, now that something happened, and they have this sense inside of them, which we have too, but we just blocked it somehow. But it was a strange feeling, and seeing the sun come up, it just touched some primordial chord inside.
I just wanna be a little birdie. I just wanna be a little birdie, birdie, birdie in a tree. A, B, C, me. I just wanna be a little birdie in a tree. Well, I heard that the homing pigeons and the lovebirds and the doves and the seagulls were all on strike. It's a big revolt. It's a big coup. It's a big coup. They all on strike. The lovebirds are saying, not me, Nazi. And the seagulls are saying that the sun is not rising to bring a fertile state. The sun is not rising to bring a fertile state. It's gonna all dry up, dry as a bone. Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-day. My, oh, my. There's gotta be another way. Down by the ocean, down by the old mill stream, things ain't the way they seem. Polly wants it faster. Woody pecker. I just wanna be a little birdie in a tree. It faster, Woody Pecker. Search for the source. My name is Pearl. I harbor no contradictions. I, rapid eye movement. I had a dream. I had a dream. Just like that of Martin Luther King. I had a dream. Just like that of Billie Jean King. I dreamed I put mind over matter, giving much time and money to the latter, 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 unto Caesar, 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 unto Caesar, what is Caesar's, and all that jive, ain't it great to be alive? Wire shocks most definitely. Oh.
Hi, this is Nancy Galloway coming to you with Community Notes here on the Village Green. Is your house as cold as it is out here on the green? Well, if it is, we have good news for you. There are federally funded programs available for you, and the one that I'd like to talk to you about today is called HEAP. HEAP is available to you to help you with your fuel bills and any emergency situation that you may have. There are several agencies available that will take your application and process it as quickly as they can. The first one that we have is Community Action, located at 436 Broadway in Kingston. Their telephone number is 338-8950. That's 338-8950. We also have the Department of Social Services available on Fair Street. Their telephone number is 331-9300. And you have to ask for HEAP assistance. The people at the Department of Social Services are more than glad to help you in any emergency situation. So if you're sitting there in a very cold home with no heat and no fuel and no money to go buy any type of fuel whatsoever, go and contact these people. For renters, the Health Department in Kingston is also glad to help you. Their telephone number is 331-4204. That's 331-4204. Now we have the HEAP hotline. That telephone number is 1-800-342-3821. That's 1-800-342-3821. Now this hotline number will give you general information for HEAP and HEAP applications. But the most important thing with this hotline is that these people will be able to mail to you applications for people who are over 60 and for people who are living on SSI and are considered to be heads of households. This is an invaluable asset for our community. It provides people who are unable to come out of their homes to obtain the type of assistance that they will need. It will provide them with heat and they won't be cold. If you know of anybody that needs this type of assistance, please don't hesitate to call any of these numbers and refer your friends and your neighbors to them. Let's have a warm Christmas and a happy holiday. Thank you.
Nancy, what happens if in the middle of the night your heater breaks down? Is there any stuff, information on that?
Just HEAP. You have to wait until the next morning, yeah, and contact HEAP.
Yeah. About the Joyous Lake reopening again, I think that there should be a show done about Ron Marion. You know, like Ron and I sometimes didn't get along. Sometimes, you know, we had fights, but that happens in the business. But he did a lot of great things in the town. He brought music to this town that nobody else. I don't think anybody else could have brought music like he did. I mean, he knew how to deal with agents. He knew how to deal with artists, and people bitched, and he bitched, and all of us bitched. We all had, you know. But he did the job, and I think the town misses him. And I would like to see something done, you know, in a show or something, that would give this man some credit for what he did.
What's he doing these days?
I don't know. Is anybody? You know, I have no idea.
They call him the former Ron Marions.
What do they say?
They call him the former Ron Marions.
Who does that? The Woodstock Times?
We saw that.
Yeah, probably. No.
Yeah, most likely it'd be the Woodstock Times.
So how did you weather that criticism of you 2 weeks ago?
It was the same guy that criticized Ron. Same guy, and it's the same person that tried to have Manny's restaurant shut down. It's the same guy. It's one guy, you know.
Huh? How do you know?
Well, because he keeps changing his name, but you know, I've heard of him. I've heard of this guy.
No. Well, did you think he was funny? Did you think, a satire? Did you think it was good satire?
He was probably, he's obviously probably right.
Who is this retard?
Well, it certainly turned me on to the column.
I said, I was once victimized, you know, by a guy that who had a way of putting words together. And he victimized me, and then I had to face my kids, you know?
Well, it's always that way. It's like, it's, you know, anytime anybody, I don't care what occupation you're in, what you're doing, you do anything, you know, that gets a little notoriety, whether it's a little bit or, I don't care what the level it is, just, you know, you're always going to get something like that. There's always going to be people around watching, you know, all the time, whether it's some schmuck on Route 212 or it's Mark David Chapman, you know, it goes from all right, levels, exactly. All the way up. Yeah. So
So what do you think? Do you think Marco Vassi should have quit? He had a hurricane of criticism.
No, I mean, I may not have agreed with his stuff, you know, but he's a talented man, you know, and I didn't agree with a lot of the stuff he said, but I liked a lot of his stuff too, and I heard him recite some of his poetry, and he's very good. But what made me mad was that he quit. You know, I mean, I would have liked to have seen him just stick the damn thing out, you know, and do it. But he quit, and that's the thing. But then again, like he said, he's spending so many hours on the column, you know, and that it's taking time away from his own writing. And I can understand. But you know, he did. I would have liked to have seen him keep going because he is talented. Whether you agree with him or not, he's an artist, you know, and he's good at what he does, and you know, and he should keep doing it. But he did create an effect. You know, he did create an effect in the town. One way, you know, he did something through his art, and I mean, not through anything violent or anything. But
people who create effects are the people who get knocked off.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, they just get so much criticism that it withers you. You know, you have to be very, very strong.
Yeah.
I guess he was aging too quickly.
Mm. Yeah. The divine path.
Right.
Yeah. But it was good.
Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite.
Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite.
Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite.
Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites,
Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites,
Marguerite,
Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites, Marguerite,
Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites,
Marguerite. Elle aimait bien les frites,
Marguerite,
Marguerite.
Elle aimait bien les frites,
Marguerite.
Delicious!
How'd the coffee come out?
You can say that.
Great. Yeah. Great!
What a ham. It really is.
Fantastic!
Are you ready for coffee?
Yeah, I sure am.
It's good.
You got sugar up there?
And Linda?
Delicious.
So what?
I think I have some.
No,
and one time with whipped cream.
Do you believe
I have a little bit of apple pie. Small.
Nancy was selling the pig jam pie.
Sugar. Oh, great. Okay. This is good nuts.
need that metal spatula. So you could get deep down into the nutty gritty.
Okay, how many more?
Do you have any pecan pie jokes?
I just took a little bit of everything. Just, you know, not too many calories, because as you can see, I'm dieting. So I just took a sliver of apple pie and, oh, maybe a taste of the pecan and coconut custard is really not my thing. So I just took a half a wedge. But now I have to cover the whole thing with whipped cream, because otherwise, you know, it doesn't have any taste unless it's covered with. I don't want to see what I'm eating. And not only that, it makes it taste better. But you know, over there I see a big ice cream cake, and I haven't had any at all. I must go over and get another piece of ice cream cake. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for the interview.
That's good, huh?
That was good, Grandma.
You know, I don't know what.
I suppose you would name them.
No, I may have my own names for them, but everybody should have their own name for them.
These are the two best ones, right?
No, they're all good. Every single one. I just picked two at random. You know this.
All right. So tell people what you got here and what you.
I've got 11 dogs here, and they're about 5 weeks old right now. And I'd like to find homes for them, good homes. And just contact me at 688-5118, and you can have a dog, you know? I mean, I wish I could do, you know, better commercials for it. If I was doing a Gene commercial, I'd show you this side, you know, and then I can show you this side here for the front. They're great dogs, you know? I mean, they're great to celebrate 1981.
They're
beautiful.
Each one is different.
Nice to take a walk with in the woods.
Yep. And this is just two of 11. There's plenty here. And they're all for free. And every person that gets a dog, that comes here and gets a dog, gets one of those. And whether you can see that on the fireplace, you get a free Christmas stocking with a dog bone in it.
Nice.
Purina. So anybody that wants a puppy, contact me, or contact Mandy Katz at Eats. He can contact me. And you can come and take one for free.
That's nice. Free.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. I guess I'd like to have some pretty straight people take them. You know? No hippies. No hippies. I don't want any hippies. You know, because
established homes.
Yeah, just people that'll. I just want people that'll take care of them, that will give them a good home.
Treat them like friends.
Or not people that'll just keep them because they're cute around Christmas time and then, you know, forget about them later.
Yeah.
Or like summer tourists that get a dog for 3 months and let it go wild in the woods when they move back to New York in the winter.
Yeah.
Or I don't want any hippies to get it that'll, you know, feed them LSD and all these other things.
Are there any more hippies with LSD?
Oh, they're all over. Yeah. They're everywhere, yeah.
Can we make a call?
And they're all in Woodstock, you know? So.
So are they?
There's more hippies per capita here than San Francisco in 1968, you know? I think they all came here. Nothing against them, I like them, you know?
You were never a hippie yourself?
Hmm?
You were always a working musician.
Well, I was always a hippie. You know?
Hi, this is Nancy Galloway coming to you from the Village Green with the last of our community notes for the evening. For those of you that feel that Central Hudson only takes and never gives, we have a surprise for you. Available through Central Hudson, Consumer Counselor Mr. Suttmeyer at telephone number 331-1510, that's 331-1510, Mr. Suttmeyer can arrange to have low interest rate loans. Let me repeat that again. There's a truck going by. Mr. Suttmeyer can arrange for you low interest rate loans for the purposes of installation. For the purposes of installation in your homes. Now, I don't have any idea what the interest rate is because the woman on the phone was unable to tell me. But these loans are available. Central Hudson will back the loans, and one of our local banks will provide the money for the purposes of installation. One woman's view, I'd like to know who's going to absorb the difference in interest rates. Thank you.
Here at the Village Green in Woodstock today.
Say it again.
I say, let's see who's getting off the bus here at the Village Green today. Being careful not to burn me. Maybe there's a celebrity or a... Hi, welcome to Woodstock.
Yeah, I just bought my first Christmas gift for a friend.
Oh,
right. And I like Woodstock. I've just come in from Kingston, and I was just saying to a lady on the bus that I always get a lift when I hit Woodstock.
When you hit Woodstock.
Oh, boy.
Woodstock does it for you.
Yeah, you get this homecoming feeling,
really?
You know.
Oh, well, have a happy holiday. Yeah. Bye-bye.
Well, to make it clear that, you know, my starring spot is...
No, that's good. That's good. I'd rather you tell me than for you to go back and say,
and do this sort of stuff where I get in front of you and say, excuse me, this is my show.
Hi, guys.
We'd love to be on TV. Nina in the new show.
Tell her to come on out.
No, you better go in there.
No, tell her to freeze her butt with the rest of us. Come on.
We need the sunlight, otherwise we
can't. Oh, for the...
Yeah, so listen, as long as you're here and you're talking...
No, I'm not talking.
You're talking.
No, I'm not really.
Well, the reason you're not talking is clear. Because you're not, thrilled by the Christmas season so far this year, right?
Of course I am.
You are?
Yeah.
So share some of that with us and our audience.
Come on.
They're looking at you. They're your friends. They're...
Well, now you've done it. Now you've done it.
They're your neighbors and they're people.
My neighbors and my friends. And
look at
why are you out here on such a cold day?
Because we had no...
had no choice. Couldn't do it in Florida.
Make it 70 degrees here. So... all your friends out there are wishing you well. Now you have an opportunity to wish them.
I have what?
An opportunity to wish them.
Wish them. Wish you well.
Thank you. You're out for your health today.
Yeah.
This is our Christmas show, and we wanted to know if you had any particular feelings about this particular season, or had any wishes for anybody, or a Christmas card?
No, not really, no.
No?
Just a nice time.
Just another day in December.
No, I mean, it's just another nice day.
Yeah, this is a good one.
Yeah.
So, what are you doing?
Just shopping around.
Did you buy anything?
Yeah, I got some bread.
Bread? How about presents and things like that?
Yeah, I cards? Get to that.
Yeah. You haven't done that yet?
No.
There'll be nothing left in the stores if you wait too long.
It's okay.
Even if there's nothing there, then your friends and people will just do without, right?
Oh, yeah, there'll be something there, right?
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah. I don't think that would ever happen, that the stores would be empty, huh?
Not
Well, thanks for making conversation with us.
Okay, it's tough, conversation like this.
I find it very easy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, that's awkward, but it's all right.
Well, season's greetings. I'm delighted. I've been 4 days a week in New York City for the past year, and I feel grounded and at home, and this is where it happens for me. It's in Woodstock, so.
This town is like a little picture postcard, isn't it?
Yes, something like it.
Is that what grounds you?
It's the abundance of nature mostly that grounds me, and the people who are more caring about each other than what happens to people when they're out, when they're so confined as in the city.
Into the stone canyons of the... Do you really think it's hard to find people that much different in New York than they are here?
People are under a lot more stress, so it's harder to be open there.
I have stress. Don't you have stress?
Oh, yeah, but I can shake it off a little better when I'm at home. And I have my home here, too, so I'm grounded
right.
in that respect. And it's good not to be running all over the place as I was.
Well, so. Season's greetings to you, Calvin.
Thank you very much.
And thanks for being on our cable show.
Well, it's a pleasure. Good luck with it all.
Okay. Really.
I write about two songs a week.
How do you catalog? How do you keep track?
Well, I found that the lousy ones you forget, and the good ones you remember. It's weird, I mean, if a song isn't that good, after 3 weeks, that's it. You don't really recall it. and a song that's halfway decent or good will stay with you, or other people will make you keep doing it. Right. People are honest, especially around here. They'll tell you if a song is, if they like something, they'll say it's good. And if they don't like it, well, they won't say, well, that's not good, but they won't say much about it. So I'll know. That's the end of that. You know, I don't end up doing it. I just wrote this about 4 days ago.
Sunlight that heals over snow.
should have known. You have one ready. You got any on the railroad crisis?
Take a card for me, free choice, anyone at all. I don't care. And, show that around, I won't take a look at it. Let everyone else see what it is, okay? All right? Have you all seen it?
Yeah.
It's reasonably important. You can dig that. And put this back in the desk. At any time you feel like asking for requests, I'll be glad to take care of them while I'm doing the show. That or cube roots, I do also. It's an old process my grandfather taught me. He was a cryptographer as well as a pool player. What am I going to do with this card? Well, let me tell you. I'm going to turn over three cards. One, two, I think these three. Each one of these cards will give me a clue to the location of your card. I'd like you to just listen and I'll explain what each clue means. The first card is the nine of clubs. That is a black card. It tells me the card you picked is either black or red. Nine of clubs. The next card is the jack of spades, a card with a relatively high value, telling me the card you selected has relatively high value. The third card is the four of hearts. Once again, would you mention a number this time, confining it to one, two, three, or four, for obvious reasons?
Three.
I'm going to count now slowly. One, two, three cards. No more, no less. The card in my hand is the card which you selected. What was your card?
Nine of clubs.
No, the card you picked and put back in the deck. What was that card?
Nine of clubs.
Nine of clubs. The card you picked and put back in the deck. Well, I don't want to get over this just yet. Think I'm cheating. You know, it's very simple. If you take, say, a sponge and put it in your hand, and if you take a sponge, hold out your hand, and just, you know, hold it out, palm up, and then close it. Put your hand out here. You see, then I just cause the one sponge to vanish from my hand. Now open your hand. You take one. You close your hand. You have one. Here, look, I have one. Watch, let me get some, I don't have... Oh, here, look. Open up your hand again. Oh. Yeah. Now, this stuff is... This is pretty crazy stuff. It's almost like they're on, well, let me get this one. Well, here, who wants to hold one? Here, you hold one of these. Close your hand. All right, and I'll take one of these. You can watch this slowly. It's a quick one. One, two, open up your hand. Getting larger. This is a real interesting trick. It's sort of a slow motion effect. I don't do too many slow motion effects because of the fantastic eye of the camera. This is my one slowdown number. It's a trick using four quarters and four cards. I suggest you watch as I do this. I'll do this relatively slowly. What I'm going to do is drop on top of each card a quarter. No, on top of each quarter a card. It's obvious to tell the difference. All I have to do is see what's on top. And watch as I do this very slowly. I'm going to cause the quarters one at a time to jump. Watch. Quarter number one, very slowly. Gone. Quarter number two, very slowly. Gone. Quarter number three, so slowly you won't believe it. I'll tell you you what, I will try to escape from these thumb cuffs. I generally make a big production number out of this, but I'm already much too hot for that stuff. I have here a pair of keys. Amazing. Thumb cuffs, yes. These were just recently called a cruel and torturous device by the LA Police Department. It's amazingly enough, but it's true. You know, when the winds of hate get to reckon of a love and the storms of jealousy destroy all the rest. Well, here, would you like to see how they work? Want to step into my office? And would you place one thumb here? Notice that what happens is this comes down. Do you use your thumbs in your work, sir? Yes. And now comes the favorite portion of the show, auctioning off the key to the highest bidder. Think what fun you can have with the man. It's amazing. I mean, he's locked up for veritably.
You can follow me anywhere.
I'll show you how this works. All you do is place this to one side, and it snaps, and then to the other side. But you can't examine them. See, there's nothing a trick about them. I can escape merely because of contractions, which I can produce in my thumbs with the help of my friend the doctor, who always accompanies me. I carry a personal physician and a safari jacket to every show. Now, what I would like to happen is to have these cuffs snapped on me, and if you would hold up your coat when I'm ready to make my escape, I will... That is not your coat? Whose coat is this? Someone's coat? It's your coat? May we use this just to drape my hands? Would you snap this down as hard as you like? God, vicious little... Yes, I'll never say it again. Rest assured that this won't happen. Amazing. Who would have known? Do you really want to... I think maybe a little more. Yeah, I appreciate your gentleness, but notice it's turning red. It's pretty weird. I'm going to attempt to escape in a record time, which is 2 minutes 12 seconds. Well, I don't suggest you look at your watches. I mean, a second or two isn't going to hurt. You'll know if I make it. Hardeen escaped in 2 minutes 12 seconds. I mean, tonight's a good night. Maybe it'd be 2:10, 2:09. Christ, the trophy with a big pig on it, right from my house. Man, it's amazing. Would you now hold up that jacket? And when I count to three, it's very important that you drape the jacket over my hands and nothing else. In other words, try not to block the audience and try not to be blocked out yourself, but just place it on my hands when I say three. One, two, three, now. No, no, don't leave go. Here, no, no, no. No, no, I'm sorry. One, two, three, now. No, no, hold it. Keep catching me in the arm hold, which is very difficult. Do this once, two, ah, never mind.
Thank you.